Hey Pre-AP, so this is the next gas laws video. So I talked about Boyles and Charles, and so the next one we're gonna talk about is Gay-Lussac's, and then also combined gas laws if we have time. But Gay-Lussac's gas laws is talking about how pressure and temperature are related, and they're going to be directly proportional, which means so as one goes up, the other one's gonna go up, as one goes down, the other one's gonna go down, okay? That is only true if all the other factors are held constant. So if you're looking at your notes, the factors that are held constant are going to be volume and moles. Volume and moles. So here's an example for you in your notes, and it talks about it. So in the summer, the pressure in the gas tank of your car increases due to the increase in temperature. So the pressure goes up because the temperature outside is going up. And as it cools down in the winter, then your pressure would go down because temperature is going down. So we have actual problems that we can calculate and plug in. And so it says, what is the new pressure on a container of gas at STP when the temperature increases to 25 degrees Celsius? So it's asking for the new pressure. So we have our formula right here, P1 over T1 equals P2 over T2. So it says at STP, so remember STP means that my pressure is going to be 1 atmosphere. And then my temperature is going to be 273 degrees Kelvin. Remember, in chemistry, we work in Kelvin for temperature. And then it asks me for my new, let's see, pregnancy brain. When the temperature increases to 25 degrees Celsius. So I'm looking for my pressure. Okay, when my temperature increases to 25 degrees Celsius. So that's 25 plus 273, so we can figure out what that is in Kelvin. And so in that case, it's going to be 298. Okay, so I'm gonna plug in. So my P1 is 1, and then my P2, or my T1 is 273. And then my P2 is what I'm solving for. And then my T2 is 298, again, because we have to be in Kelvin. So then you need to solve for the unknown. And how we typically solve for these, it's easiest just to cross multiply and divide by the third number. So you're gonna multiply the numbers across and then divide by this guy. That being said, if you wanna do it algebraically and work it out, you'd multiply both sides by 298 and then you would divide. But either way, you're gonna get the same thing. And so whenever we do that, the correct answer is, so if I take 298, multiply it, it's gonna be 1 on both sides, so I'll do it this way for you. So multiply by 298 and by 298, and that cancels. And then we have 298 over 273 equals P2. And so then I just need to divide. And so whenever I divide, I get my pressure to be 1.09 atmospheres. So P2, because I know there's a glare going on. So P2 is equal to 1.09 atmospheres. Okay, because we plugged in and we solved. So that is how we do Gay-Lussac's. So it's just another formula, another plug and chug. And so you just need to make sure that you identify. So if you're given pressure and temperature both every time, then you'll do P1 T1 over P2 T2. And then we have combined gas law. This one's gonna be a lot more applicable because in reality, a lot of things aren't held constant. And so this one is talking about whenever we have pressure, volume, and temperature all interacting and changing. The only thing that's held the same is moles. And so this one's more realistic because typically if I have a sample of a gas, the moles stay the same, but then I could change the pressure, temperature, volume. But the combined gas law is going to be P1 V1 over T1 equals P2 V2 over T2. So we just essentially took all the laws that we've been talking about and we just combine them all. And so we have example problems for this one. And so it says a 10 milliliter sample gas measured at 1.45 atmospheres pressure and 60 degrees Celsius is to be corrected to the volume it would occupy at STP. What is the new volume of the gas? So they give us a volume, 10 milliliters. They give us a pressure, 1.45 atmospheres. And they give us temperature. So that is our P1, V1, and T1. So I'm gonna plug those in, but first I'm gonna list them off to the side for you. So we have our P1, which is at 1.45 atmospheres. Okay, and then we have our V1, which is 0.01 liters, because remember we want to be in liters. And then we have our temperature, which is going to be 60 plus 273, because we would need to be in Kelvin. So that equals 333, okay, for Kelvin. And then it says, is to be corrected to the volume it would occupy at STP. What's the new volume? So I'm looking for V2, okay? And so then at STP, we know pressure is 1 atmosphere and temperature is going to be 273 Kelvin, because that's what it is at STP, standard temperature and pressure. So we're gonna plug all of this in. So I'm gonna start with my P1. I'm gonna have 1.45 times my volume, so 0.01, okay? All divided by 333 for my temperature. Okay, and then my P2 is 1 atmosphere. My V is what I'm solving, and then my temperature is 273, because that's standard temperature and pressure. So this side you can completely calculate. And so we're gonna go ahead and, isn't that fun? We're gonna go ahead and do that. So I have 1.45 times 0.01 divided by 333. And I get 4.35 times 10 to the negative fifth equals V over 273. So next I'm gonna multiply both sides by 273 to get units to cancel, to get the numbers to cancel, and that's gonna give me my volume. And so whenever I take that and I multiply by 273, I get my answer, which would be 1.19 times 10 to the negative second, or in other words, that's just gonna be 0.01. So then my volume is equal to 0.0119 liters. Okay. So hopefully that's making sense with those two examples. So again, you're just plugging and checking. It just is the math, I think, that we need the most help on. And so you have a lot of example problems. For the combined, you're gonna have a little chart that you fill in. So it gives you pressure, volume, temperature, and then you have to solve for one of the other ones on the other side. And so I'll probably end up working one of those examples out with you for your practice. But that being said, hopefully this is making sense. And I hope y'all are having a good time without me. Okay, bye.